What's up? What do I need to know, Jake?
Okay. So I got voted off at a 3-2 vote. I really don't know what happened exactly. We were planning to get rid of someone. We were planning to get rid of Kim, because I know Kim and Shannon do not get along.
Okay.
Kim and Shannon don't get along.
The girl on your tribe that did the endurance challenge?
Caroline.
Caroline. How are you with her?
I like her.
Like Pete. And Pete and Caroline know each other from a previous game. Pete's on the bottom at the Erebus tribe. Everyone voted for me except Pete. Basically, I was in an alliance with the two girls. I betrayed them to vote with the guys. So they recruited two guys, Pete, Austin and Tom, to vote me out. So it was the four of them that voted me out, and Pete's the only one who didn't know, so he was blindsided. But Pete will be loyal to you if you're loyal to him. Be like, hey, you know, David will make friends with Caroline, you make friends with Pete, we can meet up at the merge and say fuck you to both of our tribes.
I know our
tribe. Who do I need to get with on your tribe?
Right now, I don't know, because I honestly don't know what happened with my vote, because I was blindsided completely. I was in an alliance with Shannon and Caroline, but I got three votes and Shannon got two votes, and then two of us voted for Jen. So I don't really know which of the either Caroline or Shannon that backstabbed me, but one of them did. I'm thinking it was Shannon, but I don't know for sure. So
Tom has the hidden immunity idol.
Tom does? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
And Pete and Austin both
know about it.
Okay. I think Shannon has the idol on our tribe.
He was aggressive when I met him during the challenge.
He's very in your face. Terror was very in your face. Like, they're very loud, apparently, because Jen came over, told us. Yeah, Jen said that we are very loud compared to you guys, so...
Yeah, you're, it's going to be a completely different feel over there.
First of all, what the fuck? I don't know what happened. Obviously, we were trying to all vote Jen, and I knew my name was going to be on the chopping block, and I was going to play my idol, but I didn't have to, because I'm not getting voted out. So that's coming along to blindside one of these people who blindsided me. That means either, the way the vote went, that means that either Caroline or Shannon flipped on me. And I have a hint that it's Shannon, just because as soon as he voted for me, as soon as I left, he messaged me and said, I did not vote for you. That's him trying to cover his ass. I'm off the tribe. You can't communicate with me anyway. Him trying to throw in that little thing is trying to throw in that little hint of trust, so when I do come back later, I can bite him in the ass. Moving forward, I'm going to go over to Erebus and be like, hey, pick me up. I'm in the middle. Do what you want with me. keep me here because I'm going to help you get out this entire tribe on the other side who blindsided me. Why not use me? I have the idol. I'm protected. I'm going to go on far. It's your decision to keep me in this tribe in Erebus because I'm pissed off at the other tribe more than all of you. So you better keep me.
I don't even know where to start. I'm feeling a little bit salty, feeling a little bit pissed, a little bit angry, but I'm also a little bit proud of my tribe. Like, they made the right decision. So I guess, okay, let me start from the beginning. I got past phase one of the hidden immunity idol clue, and I let Tom go get the rest, and he found the idol for our alliance. He found the idol for our alliance. And so, we had our alliance chat on Sunday night. You know, all of our guys got together, and we stayed up, like, till midnight just talking with them about Survivor and about life. And I'm just, like, feeling so good. Like, I'm so glad that I feel so glad I'm working with these people because I get along with them so well, and we are all such good friends. And I trust them. It's genuinely a thought that went through my head. So the next day, Monday, I was like, I really need to talk to CJ. I haven't talked to her since Tribal. You know, I really want her to forgive me and be a fifth with us. And I talked to her, and it was a very good, cordial conversation. And all of this time, it's been in the back of my mind since before the Janicki vote that, hey, after we vote out Janicki, I'm probably the next biggest target on this tribe, and it wouldn't surprise me to see Tom and Austin join Jen and CJ and vote me out. I genuinely had that thought before we voted out Janicki. And then those fears were completely quenched by Tom and by Austin, you know? They really communicated with me, and I, you know, really began to trust them. So, sure enough, the vote comes along. 2 votes for Jen. 4 votes for me. However, there was a twist last night. I did not get voted out of the game. Instead, I got voted onto the Terror Tribe.
Oh, you could tell he was so pissed off. Oh my god.
Oh.
Oh my god. Oh shit. Yeah. I don't even know what to say. That's... Oh, I feel so bad for him. I think... Yeah, we're all speechless. I think we all should, like, go, basically. Yeah. See you guys later.
Who were the 2 votes for Jen?
This is fucked. Damn, this game is fucking crazy, yo. I wonder who we're getting on our tribe.
Yeah.
Oh boy, guys. Alright, I'll be back in a minute.
Okay. Oh, he's gone.
I don't know what happened.
I don't either. I'm really confused.
It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense if 2 people voted for me, 2 people voted for Jen. Who did you vote for?
I voted for Jen.
Then I voted for Jen. So that's our votes.
That means Jake tried to get you with Daph.
With?
He didn't tell me. Or... I don't understand.
Has Jake told you that about his idol yet?
Yeah, he told me about his idol before this. And then he was like, Shannon was really mad at me for not telling him immediately. But he said it was fine. Like, that's what he said.
Yeah. Yeah, I said that. Well, I said that not only the other day, but we had a conversation about it yesterday, just quickly. Mm-hmm. And I said, are you going to, you know, I said, I think it's best that you be open about it. And he goes, yeah, I'm just going to go to Caroline and say, and tell her that I have it.
Yeah.
He goes, I think it looks better that I've just come to her instead of her having to come to me. And I was like, well, yeah, but it's a bit late. You know what I mean? It's sort of, you know, I didn't say that, but I was like, well, yeah, well, you do that, but it's a bit late. But
yeah. Dash. This changes things. Damn.
It does. Dash is saying he did not vote for me.
Okay, well, that means Dash would have. Okay.
But there were 3 votes for Jake.
There were 3 for Jake. And that makes me, I think it's Kayla, Kim, and Jen who voted Jake. Because that makes sense to me.
So, talking about how that tribal went. I hated it. It was the worst tribal that I've been a part of yet. And I hated the fucking challenge. Simply because it felt like a real good kick in the nuts to the fact that we won our last challenge and it was all good. And everything was seeming to head in the right direction. Then when this twist comes in and now we're having to do individual immunity and having to vote one of ourselves off. And it was like, just to me, it only seemed like a win-lose situation for the person that was going to win that. And it's a lose-lose for everybody else as a whole, as a tribe. So that really sucked. What really sucked is the fact that I was expecting one vote. And I think I know who that is. But I got 2. And now I believe someone stabbed me in the back for my own alliance. And not just that, but that person ended up leaving our tribe and going to Erebus. So that was probably the only good thing that came out of it.
That came out of left field. And I'm upset because Jake looks so upset. He looks so pissed. I had to hold myself back from messaging him because I'm so pissed off.
Another thing is we set the idol to where we can't monitor what happens with it.
Exactly.
Huh?
Jake has the idol.
It's not.
Well, he can take it to the other tribe?
Yeah!
Yeah, I thought that he loses it.
Nope.
If he leaves our tribe.
Me too.
No. He keeps it in his pocket, you know, in Survivor, if you go to the other tribe, you still have it.
I was talking to Shannon, like, after everybody left, because he was like, I don't know what I'm doing anymore, and I'm just like, yikes. And he was like, his automatic assumption was that Kim, Kayla, and Jen voted for Jake. And then he was, like, bouncing between me and Jack. As to who voted for him. And like when we got off call, he was still like, I don't fucking know. And I was like,
What do you mean? So who do you think voted for Jen? Like why? Like he was the one that threw votes towards me. And oh, look, that went nowhere.
No, he voted Jen. He voted for Jen. And he's not sure if it was like Jake. I think Jake was the other vote for Jen because like we
definitely.
All did like 3-2. And then, I'm trying to think. 3-2, and then 3-2-2. So he and Jake voted Jen, but like he thinks that Jake switched his vote.
To what?
And, like that's what he thinks.
What?
Wait, well, I think we should all just like
why he would
play
get
dumb.
I am dumb
what?
Right now.
That
so
doesn't make any sense.
Friends.
No, it doesn't.
Wait, so
it
really this is what happened. So we got to just get
that doesn't
in.
Make any
like,
sense.
What?
It just doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense.
No,
how did
doesn't.
He switch his
that's
vote at the
like,
end?
I'm just telling
you. Oh, my God. Like, I don't understand it. I can... Hold on. I need a vote, Jack.
You're breaking up.
Yeah, I can't hear you, Caroline.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So Shannon voted. So Shannon voted me.
Yes.
Is that what you're saying? Yeah. Shannon and Jake voted you.
Yes. I voted Jake.
I voted Jake.
I voted Shannon.
I voted Jake.
Okay, see, that makes sense. So it was me, Kayla, and Jen voting Jake.
But I thought the plan was for you, me, for Dash, me, and Caroline to vote Jake.
It was, but then shit got mixed up.
Why?
I got confused. Like, we meant to vote Jake out. Like, we meant to do that. It just, like, two of us switched on accident, but it still worked the same way.
Oh, God. Okay, but guys, like, in the future, like, we need to, like, all, like, if we say a plan, like, we all need to stick to the plan.
Yeah.
So we voted out Jake. There was a lot of craziness and confusion about what was going to happen. So the queens kind of met up quickly and just said, like, what are we doing? And I said, I'm voting Jake. Hands down. And then Caroline was okay, or, you know, let's split it between the two of them. You know, Jake just came to me and said that he has the idol, which I thought was weird. I didn't believe that he just came to her and said it. Because it just didn't really make any sense.
Wow. Did this really happen? At the last minute, Kayla said, hey, I don't feel right about the situation. Vote Jake. And I, you know, kept thinking to myself, Kayla would never lie to me. I know that. Like, at the end of the day, I know that if, you know, out of everybody, I would trust her. And there's nothing. So at the last minute, yes, I did. I switched my vote over and I didn't vote Shannon. I voted Jake and he voted me. And I know Shannon voted me too. And, you know, if I had to choose it again, I would have chose Jake.
I don't know. But we split the vote between the two of them. It was supposed to be me, Dash, and Caroline all voting for Jake. And then Kim and Jen voting for Shannon. And I just had this really weird feeling that Caroline was doing something shady. I can't really explain it. I sent Dash a message. I was like, I don't trust Caroline. And he was like, I do. You know, just keep your vote as Jake. And I was like, well, this fool isn't listening to me. So I went to Jen and I was like, vote Jake. And she was like, I'm voting Shannon. That's what Dash told me to do. And I was like, I feel like Caroline's playing us. I feel like you need to switch your vote to Jake to ensure all the votes go to him. And she was like, what should I do? And then I felt like, oh God, what if I'm wrong? So I was just like, it's your call, it's your vote, but this is what my gut's telling me and I trust it. So at the very end, before, you know, the votes, she was like, I hope you're right. And I was like, shoot, I hope I am too. And then when the votes were read, there were 3 votes for Jake. Now, if Caroline had stuck to her word, and if Dash had stuck to his word, because who really knows who diverted? Well, then with Jen switching her vote, there should have been 4 for Jake. So that means someone switched their vote to Shannon.
Like, she does not trust me.
Oh, wait, but Caroline, going forward, I know you've been super honest with me, but some things you, like when you just sprung that on everyone at the last minute, like it's gonna make her paranoid, you know?
Jake sprung that on me at the last minute. And he was like, listen, I have the idol, what do I do? I was like, fuck, I don't know. Like, and I tried to make that very clear that he told me, like, literally 5 minutes before, like,
I know, but I think they're probably, she should be annoyed at Jen too, because like, in like how we all said who were you gonna vote, and then you.
I just like I wait, don't. Wait, like, sorry, I got. Dash, I feel like what's gonna happen is it's gonna get down to us 5, and then I'm gonna be the first one cut because we only have 3-2.
And then me.
Yeah, like those 3 are solid.
I could see that. I could see that for sure. I mean, hey, when we decided to flip this game, we committed to each other. That's what we did. So
I'm
down every week.
I'm gonna go any farther than this round. That's all I have. That's, like, what I'm getting from her. Because she's not answering my messages anymore. Like,
Kayla,
yeah, I'll message her and she does not answer me.
Oh, God. Okay, well, I'm trying to think of what we could do then. Like, so are you considering getting Kayla out before Shannon?
Yeah, because, I mean, I feel like we'll have to use Shannon if we want to take someone out of our alliance.
Okay. I don't know how I feel. Just as all is, like, literally, like, a mess, it's a mess. So we sent Jake, and of course Shannon immediately is, like, going ballistic. Shannon's, like, messaging me all the time. And, I mean, given I was the one who, like, ringleaded getting rid of Jake, but one, if we hit merge and I'm there, Jake cannot know. Two, if we hit merge, Shannon's gonna tell Jake that he voted for Jen. And I can't let that happen.
Whew, I am so, so relieved that I was able to talk Tom and Austin into saving me in this game. Oh my gosh, what a tribal that was. I just cannot believe that I was that close to going home, and I gave it my all. I told them that they should probably think with their heads and realize that a snake in this game is not going to get that much farther, and someone who's going to be loyal to them rather than chop their head off at the first time they get is probably someone better to keep in this game. And I know Tom felt kind of bad too about the fact that I laid my heart out on the line to him the night before tribal, or actually just before tribal, and he really had nothing to say to me at that time, so I know he felt bad about that. So I am so super relieved and so happy that I'm still here. I am just wondering what David is pulling on the other side.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Sorry, Pete. It was like a really tough decision, but I know you and David had kind of indicated you had worked with the girls, but I didn't feel like you had been very forthcoming, the two of you, about the situation, so that's why I voted the way that I did.
Well, I'm okay with that. I mean, this is a game. You have to do what you have to do. It's a strategy. And just like CJ said last week, and I knew that, and I've been in that position before, it would have been nice to have known it. Right, CJ?
Yeah, well, I kind of told you when you asked me to vote for Jen, like, that was absolutely not going to happen.
What I asked was if you would vote with us. Did I say Jen? I think I did.
Who else would that have been, though?
Yeah, no, you did say, would you vote with us? And then I said, you're meaning Jen, right? And then you said, yes. And then I said, I can't, you know, do that to the person that's been with me. And I can't say for sure, but I think it came down to the tribal when the decision was made, or I think we all would have liked to have given you a heads up. So the same thing that happened last tribal didn't happen this tribal, but unfortunately I think Jen's a really good speaker and she preached her case, and I'm glad it swayed the boys for me personally, because I do feel that David was possibly the biggest threat on our team, challenge-wise and social-wise, and sneaky-wise. So
David was going to make a big move somewhere along the game.
Yeah.
And so I know that. And so, like I said, I played the game, guys. It's a game. And I told somebody if it was me, it was not the end of the world. It's not. And the game goes forward. And now we have to be a strong five. And we're going to get another one in. And we're going to have to work with that person. I'm a strong six. And I'm with you guys. Now, believe it or not, but I'm with you guys.
Okay, hey, I voted for David last night at Tribal, basically because I felt most betrayed by him and Pete, and that David was playing a very slippery game, and I didn't trust him at all anymore, whereas the other people, I felt like maybe there was still like a glimmer of hope. So me and Jen decided to go David. We had a feeling he had an idol And thankfully, literally during tribal, Jen threw like a Hail Mary speech describing how untrustworthy Pete and David were, and Tom and Austin at the last second told us they were gonna flip to vote with us, which was freaking amazing, especially because I had been targeting Austin for so long. But truly the main reason why I was targeting him was because I felt that he didn't have relationships with people and that he would be an easy vote. But that wasn't the case. And now I think Austin and Tom and obviously Jen are the only people, that I can kind of trust.
Well, the morning after the scavenger hunt, the morning after the vote, the morning after the surprise of we're not voting out, we're voting someone to go to the other tribe, and the morning after the blind side. They actually voted out my buddy David, but of course David's not out of the game. He's just gone over to Terror. David will be fine over there. He has a lot going on as a player and as a Survivor fan. He knows how to handle this swap. He'll be fine. It's kind of left me in a weird predicament because I went from a strong four-person alliance to pretty much being on the bottom.
Oh my God. This twist... This fucking twist is going to ruin my game. It is going to be the reason that I lose because I'm so mad right now. I look like I'm not mad because I'm smiling because I kind of see the humor in the situation. But I'm pissed because I voted out David out of the game and it was a big blindside and it was a big backstab. Like, he gave me a fucking idol. He gave me an idol, and I voted him out of the game, but he's still in the game. And not only is he still in the game, he's on the other tribe, able to say whatever he wants about me and Austin. And it can't be good what he's gonna say. Like there's no way in hell that there's gonna be anyone in this game after today that doesn't know I have an idol.
He's probably so sad, yeah.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey,
hello,
Jake.
How is everyone?
We're nervous. Hi. We're excited. What about you?
Pretty good.
That's nerve-wracking.
Do you want to introduce yourself to us? Do you want us to go first? Would that make you feel better? Or do you want to talk about yourself first?
Whatever you guys want to do. You guys are... I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio. I'm Jake, obviously. Hi. Last name round, like a soccer ball. And, yeah, I'm a student at the University of Cincinnati. I'm a biology major. And my favorite color is green. And I did lose the immunity challenge first because I'm obviously in a dorm, so I don't have much. The first question was like a spoon. I'm like, I don't have a spoon. I have a meal plan. So that was fun. But yeah.
But you didn't have an option to be in the house if you're in a dorm.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah. So I was a little left hanging.
Welcome. Yes, we've all introduced ourselves, but you know us, and you just heard Jake.
Hey, Jake.
Hi. How are you feeling?
Okay. Better. That's good. Yeah. That's good. So we didn't actually get to, like, introduce each other before.
Yeah, not really.
Someone actually had mentioned to me that you live in Cincinnati, so I'm probably, I don't know, I'd say 25 minutes from you.
Are you, what part of Cincinnati are you from?
Well, I'm from down by where you live, but I live in Morrow, so it's by Kings Island. Yeah, so, like, are you happy to be over here?
You can be honest.
Honestly, just got voted they out. Are crazy. They are honestly crazy. Oh, yeah. And Jen, I think you sort of, like, got hit of that when, like, last tribal, when we had Jordan get voted out. Crazy. Yeah.
Man, like, I told them, you go ahead.
Like, I think I, honestly, because when Jordan, like, everybody was against Jordan, and you probably got a hit of that when you were there, and she thought of me as her, like, ride or die or whatever, so I had to keep telling her what she wanted to hear, and then I think that got, like, people distanced from me as well, so I think that burdened me, and that's why I'm here now, but...
Gotcha.
I mean, it got Jordan out, so...
Yeah.
Was your tribe united in your vote against you? I mean, you don't have to tell me. I'm just curious. Yeah.
Nope. It was a huge blindside.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it was 3-2-2. Like, what was the vote? That was 3-2-2.
Wow.
Yeah, close.
So, is there, like, a 5 there that, like, feels really tight and comfortable enough to split their vote or something?
I honestly have no idea, because I was in, like, a solid 3, and apparently the other side was a solid 5, but we didn't see it, and someone on my 3 flipped on me, and I don't know which one it was, so I'm completely in the dark. So I'm literally just here.
I just happen to be here.
Yeah, at this point.
Think anyone has the idol over there?
Yeah.
I have my suspicions of who has it. And I think because they split the vote between me, I guess they thought I had it, but they split the vote between me and someone else. And that's who I think who has it as well. So
will you tell us?
Yeah. Shannon, I think the Australian guy.
I got voted onto the new tribe, or to the other tribe, which is now a new tribe, I guess, the new Erebus. I like everyone over here. Everyone's nice. Everyone talks to me. Everyone is inclusive. And they care about what happened to me. They care about who I got voted off. And they're giving me information that I asked them. Even in a group setting, I'm able to ask them what happened in their last vote, because I know it was a blindside, because I talked to David. And they openly talked about it, which I thought was strange, but they must be that close and be able to talk about that with the people you just blindsided, as in Pete. I thought it was strange, but that must mean that the majority of the tribe must feel comfortable, as in Jen and CJ. I feel like they're comfortable, and that's never a good thing to be in Survivor, and I hope David finds a crack in the Terror tribe, because after my vote, I know they're going through a tailspin. I know they're falling out. And if he's able to side with Caroline and all of them and is safe for these next votes to the merge, I think I can have a true relationship in this game with him, because he is someone that went through the same thing I did, being switched over to a tribe of whole new people. And in those 5 minutes that we had together to give information, we connected really well. We explained all that we needed to. Yeah, I threw a few lies in there on who I thought had the idol, as in I kept saying Shannon, because that's how the votes went. They tried to split the vote between me and Shannon, so I just told them that they thought Shannon had it. That's who I thought had it, too. I can't tell them. I'm going on to a new tribe that no one knows that I have the idol. So that put me in the best position possible. And I think if David can get to the merge, I feel like with this Erebus tribe, we'll have majority then. Because I feel blindsided by all of them. There's no way I'm going to try to work with them later on if I don't have to.
Hello!
Did not expect that, David! You just...
How's it going?
Whoa!
Why didn't you expect this?
No. Well, I'm angry at you because you beat me like by like 4 minutes in the last challenge. And I was like, I've got this. 7 minutes. I typed everything out so well. And then you come in with 4 minutes, you bastard.
I'm sorry. I didn't know that was you. I wasn't paying attention to who my opponent was. I did it after the challenge was over. I knew we had lost, so I had no pressure. So I just went on there and was like, I don't care. Here's the differences I notice. And she told me I won, and I said, I think it's only because I didn't care. Like, I didn't spend extra time on it because I had no incentive. And so I think having no pressure helped. That's the only reason. It's not that I'm actually that great at spotting faces and pictures.
It was a case of just being online at the right time and also not at my boyfriend's house. I was on my laptop, and then a call came in, and it was the announcement that David had joined our tribe. Seriously. Didn't expect it, but then again, I haven't really been studying anything about the other tribe. Like, I figured it wouldn't be Jen. That's kind of like the only conclusion I'd come to. And so the fact that it was David, who's like been killing it in every challenge, I just figured he was strong. And socially, he seems like really nice. And from the a time we had the announcement and all that, that when the challenge would be on or something, when it was like a 5 minute announcement, he just seemed like super nice. Like, you could just tell he had this sort of charisma. So I figured that the vote had come down to him being strong. But yeah, good timing and all. I was the only one sort of online at the right time for about a good 10 minutes before Jen hopped on, so I worded him up.
I don't know if this is very forward of me, but I just got voted out of my old tribe, and you and I are already alone on this tribe. Is there anything I need to know to make sure I'm not the next person gone?
So, okay, my advice before anyone picks up, and if I'm going to be a strong player and I have to be strategic because my time zone, I'm not generally the first one on, is if you want to be in the majority, don't befriend Shannon.
I wasn't planning on it. I met him during the endurance challenge and he was loud and crazy.
I'm more sort of playful and crazy, but not aggressive and crazy out of the two Aussies. But after the last vote especially, he is on the outer.
What happened?
So what I told her was, it was part challenge strength. Like, I was told maybe like a week ago that, you know, that people around the tribe were saying they didn't want to take me to the merge. Because of challenges. And so, like, and these were people in the alliance I made on day one. So when I started to hear that, I basically made a different alliance to vote against my original one that were talking behind my back about voting me out. And I guess, I'm not sure exactly what happened, but I guess my old alliance found some people to switch over to their side to get revenge on me this time. What? Which is fair. I guess I had it coming. You know, they're like, he stabbed us in the back, and I had to be like, yes, I did. I'm sorry. Like, you know, I don't like. I'm not like a Russell Hansen stabs people in the back for fun. It was because, like, they said, hey, we're gonna give David two more rounds, and then he's gonna go. No. So I honestly, even if I stuck with my alliance, I would have been voted out this tribal council based on what I was hearing anyway. Like, I would still be here.
So bye bye, Jake, and hello, David. Well, my first impression was, he was very honest, you know, straight to the point, says that, you know, he was an alliance and he turned on them and went another alliance. And, yeah, it sounds real sketchy. It does. I'm not going to lie. But the fact that he came to us and was straight honest about it means something. I mean, everybody has to get something for honesty. I mean, come on.
Yeah. No, look, we've got you, Jen and I, like, you know, I wouldn't have said about Shannon unless I was confident that I wanted to, you know, do something to not, for you not to be the obvious first vote, because okay, we're awesome. All still reeling from the last one, and Shannon mm-hmm. is probably doing lots of scrambling, so it is better for our game to keep you around and, right. you the know, merge. It sort of
give I have Shannon some to go back to them after the merge. Sure. Yeah. And I could in it, and I could even. We obviously will have the numbers because we already have the numbers, and we're just going to keep winning immunities from here on out.
Right.
But, if for some reason we need Pete, I can bring him over. He has a pre-established relationship with Caroline.
He does.
They played in Foot Survivor together.
Interesting.
Huh. And Caroline. Caroline, we know that you know Peter.
I'm sorry, I let that cat out of the bag.
She's like,
you know him from a previous game.
Hey, you didn't tell us about that.
Because I don't want to be known as the person who knows Pete, because Pete is a crazy little dude. Like,
no, you know.
He's crazy. I get the impression. He's actually crazy, and I was hoping he would be first out so I didn't have to talk about it.
Is this any consolation? Like, Pete didn't offer up that information. I think I'm the only person he told because I called him out on it. After the endurance challenge, I said, wow, that girl was really strong, so I looked you up on Facebook and saw that Pete was a mutual friend, and so I asked Pete, I said, how do you know Caroline? And he said, I was going to keep this a secret as long as I could, but we played real foot together. And I was like, well, did you get along? He's like, we haven't really talked much since the game. I was like, okay.
Yeah, we really haven't, because I was just like, old people.
Sure, I'll be right back. Hey, give me 1 second.
There is hope from Merge. Everyone does know that me and Pete know each other now, so fuck. Thanks, David. Not like that meant anything. Like, everyone knows Pete and I know each other. Dash is the only one that knows the real story behind it and how I played real foot with him. And I told Dash that we played real foot. I told everyone else that we played a game. And that's that. And everyone's like, okay, great. You can pull in Pete when we get to the other side. David loves Pete. It's going to be set. And I'm just like, yeah, okay. Cool. So we're just going to have to see how it goes.
Looking most forward to meeting for like all 24 hours.
Really?
Well, okay, so it was because you're, first of all, the intro video, you're like the first one and you like jump off the screen. It's awesome. And then when we had the trivia challenge, it was like, after I was really pissed at Austin for how badly he did, I was like, holy crap, Dash kicked butt in this Survivor trivia. So he's clearly a person after my own heart. And then I got to this tribe, and basically, like, when people were telling me about the tribe, they were like, you have to meet Dash, he's amazing, he's the coolest. And this is from, like, all 6 other people, however many people, 5 other people.
Really?
So, yes, you came with very high recommendations. Sweet. So I'm like, I have to meet. So I left our group call because everyone was sitting on the group call like this.
Okay, good. I'm happy because I honestly just wanted to talk to you.
Okay, good. I got what I think. So I was just like, hey, guys, I'm going to go.
Yes, yes. Okay, cool. So I want to, like, get to know you, and then we can talk game, like, after.
That's perfectly fine.
So you're a Survivor freak as well?
Yes, just classic, super. Take, like, Adam Klein from this current season, but no one in my family has a life-threatening disease right now, but same Survivor fan trajectory.
I'm telling you, like, we have a clean slate. I feel like we have a very honest relationship, like, so far. I mean, I want to keep it that way. Like, you know, it's just like, let's keep it 100 with me, and I will always keep 100 to you. That's the truth.
For sure. This is my second chance. This is, like, my clean slate, you know, like, my life got saved. So, like, you know, like, I'm learning from my mistakes of last round of, like, you know, don't. Be shady to your allies. Just be, you know, if I had just been real with them and said, hey, I don't feel good about Janicki, like, I wouldn't be in this place right now.
Yeah, that's so true.
So, yeah, I'll be honest with you for sure.
Even if we go to travel, like, you're not going home. Like, I will protect you, I promise. I'll do everything in my power.
Thank you.
And,
In the end, obviously, you know, I don't have the context of everything that's going on in this tribe, so, like, I have no intention of getting in the driver's seat for this first vote. I'm just looking for someone awesome like you to be like, hey, please vote with my majority, and we're going to...
I mean, we'll see what happens. Like, if it was up to me, I want Shannon to go, personally.
You're not alone from what I've been told, so...
Oh, really? Okay, good. So, like, that would be my personal vote because I know, like, the thing about Shannon, okay, like, I'll be, who are you rooting for in this election?
Hillary.
Okay, thank God. Oh, my God. Okay, I don't like Hillary, but I like her a shit ton better than Trump. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wanted Bernie Sanders. I'm like,
yeah.
I'm like total hippie, like, so yeah, like, let's just smoke a blunt and like have peace and equality.
This round, a lot has been going on. David and Jake switched tribes, and everyone was buckling up to get ready for one of the biggest challenges of the season. In the meantime, Erebus has chosen Pete to be a captain, as well as Terror choosing Caroline. This round, the cast was given a scavenger hunt. Basically, they had a list of 100-something items. Whichever tribe finished the list first would win the challenge and would be safe from tribal council. Let's see how they did.
Just fine before I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart. Moved to the city and I broke down crying. 4 years, no calls. Now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar and I in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older.
You, I forget just why I left you. I was insane. Stay and play that Blink 182 song that we beat to death in Tucson. Okay, I know it breaks your heart. Moved to the city and I broke down crying. 4 years, no calls. Now I'm looking pretty in a hotel bar. And I can't stop. Shoulder, pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older.
In a close finish, having both tribes complete the entire list, Erebus beat Terror by 15 minutes, completing 216 items. Terror will be going to Tribal Council.
So, this is a first.
Not a tap.
You guys. So, we've never done Scavenger Hunt like this before, where we give a list and you have to finish the list. We've never done that. It's always do as much as you possibly can and go absolutely nuts until the last moment. So, as you can tell, we are done early. And at the last minute, they found their British pound coin. They found Billy Garcia to make them a video. But you guys finished first. Erebus wins immunity.
Survivor winners!
Nice.
And those British pounds were hard to find, just let me tell you.
Oh, were they ever? Yeah.
Let's go. Erebus won the scavenger hunt. Yes, this was a huge win for our tribe. We're so happy not to go tribal. We've had to go to tribal council two times in a row. One by default because both tribes went. But still, two tribals in a row. Two crazy tribal councils at that. First with the Janicky vote and CJ and Jen being completely blindsided and pissed off at the guys. And then the David vote where me and Tom switched at tribal council. And we're hoping to vote Tom out, but kind of find out he gets switched to the other tribe. So this was just really big for us to win this challenge and not have to go to tribal council. I know it's a huge morale boost for everybody. And especially, I know Jake was definitely worried about being on the outs. So I know it's got to be a big morale boost for him. He hasn't been down. His morale hasn't been down. He's been very happy and energetic all the time. But I mean, this got to be even bigger morale boost for him to say, hey, I got some more time with these people. Get to know everybody. I'm not going to, he'll always be the new guy, but we'll actually get to know him more and better. And it's not just going to be everybody running around doing crazy scavenger hunt stuff. We're actually going to get to talk to him and know him a lot better personally and how he plays this game.
I really didn't. I thought there were some things that there was no way people on Erebus were going to do.
I didn't think they were going to get to
them. Because they are, like, especially the two girls are so, like, time crunched, like they don't ever have time to do anything. So, but I was like, we hate so bad because Jen never has time. She and CJ never has time.
I bet Jake did like a ton.
Yeah, because he's probably like in my position where he knows, like, hey, I'm new to this tribe, I need to do my shit.
So we got the list on Wednesday. I think it was. And it was like almost 300 items, which was scary because there's six of us. And Dash figured out that that comes to like 47 points each person had to earn in order for us to get them all. My initial thought was, why do we have to get them all? Erebus is not going to get them all. Let's just do as many as we can, as fast as we can. We had 72 hours to do it. And I was the first person to start uploading things when it came down to it. And I think part of that, though, was people jumped on signing up for different tasks. And some people really got on, like, super easy things. In all honesty. Like, I'm not gonna sit here and say, like, I did better than anyone else. But if you're just looking at numbers, yeah, I did the worst. But if you're looking at the difficulty involved in each of the tasks, you know, Caroline did a lot of photos, which are a lot easier than videos. Like, you know, I feel like I did some pretty big things. Like, I cut my hair. I did carpool karaoke. That was time consuming. I went out and found a house with a red door, posed in front of it. You know, I did the jelly beans. I had to go out and buy them. I did the gum. Had to get that. I drank pickle juice. Like, I did a lot of things that weren't super easy.
Kayla, you scare me when you say, we need to talk. Like,
we do. We do need to.
I shit like three bricks. I'm like trying to build a house.
Why are you so scared?
I don't like in life when people tell me we need to talk, because then I'm like, what did we need to talk about? Like, I get really scared and I get paranoid.
Why are you paranoid?
But please don't do that. Oh, really, girl? So now you don't trust me?
Not at all.
I'm just like, who's talking shit?
Shannon.
Oh, girl.
He's not talking shit. But I did talk to him today. And he told me that Caroline said she voted for Jen.
But then who the fuck did Jake vote for?
Apparently Shannon.
What? That makes no sense.
That's what I said.
I'm so fucking confused.
But why would Caroline tell Shannon that?
Oh my god, I'm so fucking confused, Kayla. What the fuck?
I don't know.
These people trying to play with us.
I'm just telling you what he said.
No, I'm glad you are. I mean, so Caroline voted. Why the hell would Jake vote Shannon? That makes no sense.
He said the reason was because Kim sent Jake a message right before the vote saying, I'm with you 100% or something like that. And the two of them decided to vote for Shannon.
I'm shook.
All I have to say is he was...
Why do these people not keep it real? Like, I'm sorry. Thank you, Kayla. You keep it real. Like, thank God.
Yes.
What would you... Like, I'm the only one who kept it real besides you. I mean, Jen did too, but, like, Jen didn't tell me that she was switching. She told you.
In her defense, she didn't
get up
on her own. I went to her.
Yeah, true. No, I trust Jen. And I trust Kimberly, too. But, like, what the fuck? What do we do?
I don't know, like, how much trust you put into Shannon, but, like, I'm telling this as a friend because I, like, love you.
I love you, too.
Want you to know, like, I would expect you to do the same for me. But he was talking about how he's caught you in all these lies and stuff.
Well, I was lying to him, so that's true.
Oh, no, and I know that. And everything he was saying, it wasn't anything that was news to me. Like it was all, like he was saying, you said you were going to vote for Kim. And then, so, like, everything was in favor for me. But the things he was saying about Caroline, like, he said that she voted for Jen. She showed him proof. Yeah, that's the only thing that got me, because I was like, I don't believe that happened at all. But then he was like, sure of it.
Okay, so I just talked to my mom to clear my head, and I needed to do another confessional because I just decided I need to vote out Caroline. Like, I'm sorry, she's gaming hard. She's the best player here, besides me, probably. She is super manipulative. She is a great liar. I can't let her align with Pete because she literally liked his pictures and I couldn't like them, which means me and Pete are not friends. And then I checked his friends list and Caroline isn't there. So she deleted him, trying to hide the fact that her and Pete know each other. Plus, her and Jake still trust each other. She has Shannon. At the end of the day, Kayla, Jen, and Kimberly have been the ones who kept it 100 with me this whole time. And like, yes, Caroline does trust me, but some of her antics are just so super shady. And like, I can't trust it. I need to do what I did with Jordan. Even though I love her as a person, I need to cut off emotions and think logistically. Shannon is fucking useless. No one's gonna want to work with him. I'm sorry. Like, Shannon's not winning this game. Period. Caroline can actually win. I need to get out the threats. I need to be running this shit. If she goes, I gotta get her out. I'm sorry.
Oh boy, so are you excited for tomorrow? How do you feel?
A little bit nervous, man. A little bit nervous. I'm hearing some crazy things, so
Have you heard anything? What's happening?
I mean, what are you hearing that's so crazy?
Well, we know Kim's coming after me. That's something that we're all for certain.
Yeah.
Apparently Caroline might be on board with that.
On board with Kimberly out or you out?
No, voting me out.
I don't think Caroline would do that.
Yeah, I think there's some reasons that I've sort of come across and sort of had some time to sit on. There's some reasons why she would vote me out.
Like what?
So, well, with the whole Last Tribe thing, it was undecided who voted for me. You know, it was either going to be her or Jake that did it. And I think for now, like, I don't know what her reason would be trying to vote the first time around, but to get me out this time, I think she might be wary that if we make it to merge, and I started chatting to Jake again, she might be worried at the fact that she was gunning for me the first time, and that would be where I would actually find out whether or not if Jake did or...
Welcome, Terror, to your third Tribal Council. As always, we will start this off with a question and answer ceremony. This is the final frontier for you to fight to stay in your expedition. Kimberly, expedition is one hell of a game, but it comes with a lot of stress. So how do you, well, actually, have you been coping with the stress of the game?
That's a very direct question, and you know I haven't. It has been really tough because even from the start, I questioned my own sort of ability to just, like, meet people and then have to sort of vote them off one by one, and the inability to sort of know when people are online or know time differences, it has been a struggle because you just don't know, I don't know everyone's schedules, and so yeah, it's been hard. I don't think I've coped that well, but mostly everyone has been quite encouraging and supportive, and lots of virtual hugs.
Do you think as the game progresses, you'll get better with your emotions?
I bloody hope so. I bloody hope so for my own sake. And, you know, I definitely don't want to be seen as a quitter or weak just because I'm overtly emotional. So I'm going to try my bloody hardest.
Let's talk about the challenge. You chose to sit out the challenge this round. Do you feel like that will have any effect on the Tribal Council? And do you think you're to blame for potentially the tribe losing the challenge since you didn't participate?
I thought, you know, for the fact that from what I've seen in the other challenges and on YouTube, I figured that location-wise, it was going to be really tricky for me. I don't drive, so there's that. Plus, I only work in a city sort of, I live and work in a city sort of area, so I figured that I'd be hindered on getting a lot of the items that I could get. Plus a lot of them seem like dares and I'm not that bold.
David, last time we saw you had a blue buff on. Now you wear red. Wanna kinda update us on what happened in the world of David?
Oh my gosh, this game. Oh, this game has been an absolute roller coaster of the last few days. I went from thinking, oh, can you hear me? Yeah. Huh? Yeah. Yeah. No, this game has been an absolute roller coaster the last few days. I went from thinking I have this great group of not just an alliance, but friends on the other tribe, to being completely blindsided by them at the last tribal council. Coming here to Terror, going from that complete low, I think everyone I met on the first night I was here was thinking David's probably crazy because I was livid. My head was spinning. I was angry. My emotions were flying everywhere.
And then after about 2 days, I had this great high because I fell in love with everyone on this tribe. Like, they are nice, they are energetic, they are smart. Like, I believed Terror after getting to know these people. And then we did this challenge, and it was stressful and exhausting and tiring, and we just barely lost. And now we're here at Tribal, and I still have scars from last Tribal. I wanted Erebus to lose. This is a revenge mission for me. And just knowing that Erebus is sitting on their ship right now praying that I'm going to get voted out absolutely sucks, and I'm scared and paranoid.
You were probably debatably the strongest competitor on Erebus, and they voted you out anyways. Now you're on Terror, same things going on, doing good in challenges, succeeding, but how do you make sure that this new tribe doesn't vote you out like your last one did?
I came to this tribe knowing that they all unanimously voted for Jordan. And so I knew that I was going to be on the outs. You know, Jen at our tribe, when we went on the expedition, she said that they are all very close. So I knew that all I could do was come over here and make friends. And if I'm only going to be in this game for one more round, I might as well have as much fun as I can. And that's what I've done. I've made friends with everyone on this tribe, and they have been extremely welcoming to me. They have made me feel like a part of the team. And to a certain extent, they've made me feel relatively safe. You know, I don't know if I can, you know, you never know if you can believe what people tell you, but I hope I'm still here tomorrow.
Shannon, so how do you feel about losing the scavenger hunt challenge?
I feel like we got robbed, man, to be honest. We got robbed from that challenge. 25 minutes out, we had the... You know, the final items just ticked off, and I thought we had it just because, you know, some of those items were quite tough to get. You know, and everyone put in 100% for this challenge, and you can't take that away from anybody. So
I think it's fair to say that originally Terror was the tribe to beat, strong, competitive, and winning all the challenges. What happened? Because now it seems like Erebus has picked up this momentum. And I wonder, and I ask you, how do you fix this? How do you end their momentum and gain it back?
You stop it by coming together as a team and working together as a team better. You know, there's always something to pick at with each challenge that we do. You know, no matter how well we thought we did it, there's always a way to improve it. And that's something that this tribe will need to do moving forward. We have to, you know, we have to all communicate, because that's a big, strong point of what we need to do. And we need to communicate about what was the down sections of the last challenge, what made us lose, and correct it. Because you look at how quick we caught back up in those final moments. In the last couple of hours, we caught back up real quick. If this was a straight sprint challenge, I feel like we would have won straight up.
So, Strannon, what are you basing your vote on tonight?
I'm basing my vote on... It's not really a strategic one. It's an obvious one. It's an obvious vote that needs to happen. Whether this person realizes it or not, they've indirectly affected this tribe from just a small, minute thing that they've done. And in a way, they've done exactly what Jordan did. So I don't want that to happen for the future survivor. So, you know, for our team. So I think it's best that we remove this person.
Okay, so Kayla, last tribal council, you guys got rid of Jake. How's life been since?
It's been a whirlwind. I think David was like a breath of fresh air coming on to Terror. He definitely slayed in the challenge. He did awesome. Everyone did awesome. I think for me personally, like, I have definitely felt better about the whole tribe. I feel like I've gotten to know people a lot better. Since Jake left, I'm like totally honest about the fact that he and I didn't really connect at all. And I feel like it kind of gave me the opportunity to connect with some people I hadn't yet. So,
I feel like we've been a lot more united since the last tribal. I wanted to vote for some, well, I voted for Jake because I didn't feel safe as far as, like, his game was concerned. He was a strong competitor. Like, I'm not going to not give him credit for that. But as far as, like, I felt lucky that I had individual immunity because I don't know how the vote would have gone if I hadn't. I might have been in Jen's position. I might have gotten those two votes on the side. So I don't know. My criteria was just I wanted to keep people around that I felt safe with.
It's safe to say at this point it's everyone's goal to make the merge. I'm curious, Caroline, what do you think the chances of you making the merge is?
I certainly hope I do. My social game has been definitely lacking this week, and I've been, like, not exactly in, like, the best position, like, with the people on my tribe. Like, just social-wise, kind of haven't been really available. So I don't really know what's going on. Definitely. I'm very, very nervous, and whether or not I should be or not, I'm not sure. But I can't, like, I've been trying not to, like, make it, like, a big deal and make it, like, apparent, but I'm not very concerned. I have doubt. I definitely trust, I have trust in my tribe, and I feel like a lot of what's going on is just my own paranoia and my own, like, fear.
Jennifer, from my perspective, you slayed this past competition, but you guys still lost. How do you feel about your participation, and how are you guys going to get out of the stink that is Tribal Council? I'm tired of seeing you guys.
I put in everything that I had in me, like, literally, like, every tear, just to prove that I still can be a good part of this tribe. And, you know, hearing my name last time really kind of, it hurt a little bit because you don't expect, you know, people that you like will vote you off, but it's not really what it's about, I guess, sometimes. But, yeah, it sucked. But like I said, I really killed the last, we didn't win, so I can't really say I killed it, but honestly, our last challenge, I think we all tried to do it right. Everyone worked so hard, and it was just proven that we do have a good tribe. We just need to continue to work hard, and that's the only thing we can do is stay tight and continue to work hard.
Bash, last round, you guys voted out Jake, who was an extremely strong competitor. In turn, you received David, and you guys went on to lose the next challenge. Though David is a strong competitor, does this mean you need to reevaluate your tribe a bit?
I'm not worried. I'm happy to have a guy who's great at competitions on our team fighting for us. But as far as the whole strengths and weaknesses thing, I do believe that every person has their own set of strengths and weaknesses. And it's about positivity and sticking together and just believing that we can do it. And I feel like if whichever six people survive tonight commit to believing that we can win and get all the way to the top six, then I feel like we can do it. Honestly, I just feel like we need to keep committed to what we just did. Like, if we had just started earlier, this last challenge, we would have won. Like, we got everything done. We did an amazing job. Everybody really gave it their all, in my opinion. And we worked together as a team. If we had just started earlier, so I think from last challenge, what we need to learn is the second the challenge hits, we need to start strategizing. We need to get on the same page, make group calls. Let's figure out how we're going to beat these bitches' asses. That's how I feel. I want them to go home so we have numbers at the merge.
Last question, and we'll head into the votes. Dash, what are you going to base your vote on tonight? Is it loyalty? Is it challenge strength? Where do you find the right choice?
I mean, for me personally, I feel like the number one thing at the core of my vote is always going to be based on loyalty. And, like, I think my vote is, I think, because the merge could happen, like, tomorrow. Like, you could just be fucking with us. Like, we don't know the tea. So it's like, I feel like you need the six people that are actually going to stick together. So I'm voting for the person I think is most likely to flip.
Once the votes are read, the decision is final. The person being asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. If you have the hidden immunity idol, now is the time to play it. I take it no one's playing an idol tonight. Let's get to the votes. First vote goes to Kim. Second vote goes to Shannon. The third vote goes to Shannon. The fourth vote goes to Shannon. We are 3-1. One more vote, and Shannon, you will be voted out. The fifth vote, and the next person voted out of Expedition the Northwest Passage. Shannon, it's time you bring me your torch.